Namaste, and welcome to another video in our Be Your Own Guru series. Today we're going to talk about meditation. In particular, we're going to talk about your seating posture for meditation. So I'm going to show you some right ways and wrong ways, although if you're meditating, I guess in some ways there's no wrong way, but there are better ways. Let's put it that way. So as you can see, I'm sitting what we would call Indian style, right? Now, if you're really good, you can do a half lotus. If you're even better, you can do a full one. I can no longer do a full one because I haven't done yoga since before COVID. But the idea, if you're going to sit in this traditional posture, because everyone wants to be the guru, right? Everybody wants to, all those photos you see online, well, they're just stock photos. And I can tell you almost all of them are wrong. I'm always horrified when I see these models sitting, and I used to be a model, so I used to do stock photography, so I know what it's all about. So they hire a bunch of models and they come in and just take standard, you know, shots that people will buy that they need for their advertising. And certainly these days, someone sitting in a position for meditation is a big one. And every time I see them, they're wrong. So I'm going to show you why and what's right. So first of all, if you're going to sit in the cross-legged position, this is more of that Eastern style, the Hindu style, Buddhist style, that Ayurvedic medicine, you sit this way. And the idea of sitting this way is you put your fingers together and you're all crossed, right? So the energy is staying within your being. You're flowing the energy. That's why the legs are crossed. That's why you touch your fingertips. You're flowing the energy within. So that's one way of doing it. I'm going to teach you about being open to receiving in information in the next portion of this. But right now, let's talk about this position. First of all, your knees should always be in line with your hips or slightly lower than your hips. So I have a bolster underneath me, and I'm pretty flexible so I can get down there. You can, you know, obviously you can just be Indian style like this. So you see, if I'm Indian style, my hips are here and my knees are here. So they're pretty much in line. The knees are slightly tilted forward, which is fine, which is perfect. And let me show you what you don't want to do and what you always see in these stock photography pictures, right? So I'm going to take away the bolster because they never have a bolster. They're usually sitting like this in Indian style with their knees up. And yeah, that's a great place to rest your hands, but that's putting strain on your lower back, and it's actually can make it that you're arching your back to sit straight, and you don't want your back arched. You want your spine straight, and you can't do it like this. It's just, it's impossible. I'm trying to do it and I can't because my knees are higher than my hips. Let me show you that from the side, right? So when you see those photos, they're like this, right? And yeah, nice picture. Take a picture of me, make some money, sell my photo, that kind of thing, right? My back is arched to sit straight like this. It's not comfortable. If you were to sit like this for a half an hour in a decent meditation, or if you're really good, go an hour, or even if you're just doing 10 or 20 minutes, you're going to have back pain from doing that. So this is improper. Now let me show you from the side. If you take a bolster, you could take a blanket, roll it up, you know, a pillow, just something so that you get your knees a little, you know, either equal to your hip or slightly lower is actually preferred. When I sit outside, I usually find a rock that's a little slanted or on a hillside, and that naturally will boost me. And now I can sit with my spine straight without arching my lower back. This is so much more comfortable. So for those of you who've been afraid to meditate, you're like, I can't sit in that posture too long. No, you're right, you can't. But if you do it properly, you can sit much longer, much more comfortable, because you want your back straight. You don't want an arch like this, which is what we had before. You want your back straight, as though there's this like puppeteer wire in your spine, and you just want it straight. And then you can rest your hands on your knees. They're still gonna hold you. They don't need to be up here to hold you. So that's how that would look. Now, let me show you another way you can do something very similar to that. That's yoga style. And again, let me just show you this from the front. So again, keeping that level, your knees level with the hips, and then you can go into your meditation. So let me show you another version of that. So another thing you can do is, if you don't have a bolster, you can get a blanket, right, and roll it up nice and tight. And this is a yoga pose, actually, and it's great to do after you eat a big meal to help with digestion. So we're just gonna kind of straddle it like that with your knees. So now you can see my knees are lower than my hip, and this is so comfortable. You can kind of just sit here and go into any kind of meditation that works for you, whether it's mindful meditation where you are aware of your thoughts, because you can't always shut them down, and you think about the thoughts, but you're aware of them. You're the observer. You're being mindful of your thoughts. Or if you want to just go into focusing on the breath. And we have a whole free series on breath work, which we'll put a link in below that you can learn more about breath work, because breath work is the foundation. Besides this being the foundation, your breath work is your foundation, because the more you can focus on your breath, the less you even have to be mindful of your thoughts, because you'll have less of them when they come up. When they do occur, then you can be mindful of them, shoo them on their way, and then go back into focusing on your breath or a one or two word mantra. This is a great position because you can easily sit here for 20 minutes. Now, some people always ask, well, can I lay down in a meditation? Well, you can. Now, when I would do the group meditations and we do the sound bath and I'd take people through a guided journey, if people lay down, sometimes they fell asleep and then they'd start snoring, and that would obviously disturb the other students. So I usually wouldn't allow them to lie down, or if they did and they fell asleep, I'd have to go nudge them. So if you lie down, if you're someone who can fall asleep easily, I would recommend don't lie down for a meditation, because you might just fall asleep. Although the Dalai Lama said even sleeping is meditation, so I guess that's okay. But it's good to have some position that you use all the time. Now, I always sat up in a chair, which I'll show you next for mine, or I did the more yoga poses. But I have started lying down to meditate, and it's basically because I'm meditating first thing in the morning before I get out of bed, because I've learned with my hectic life, if I don't do it then, it doesn't usually get done. So I will lie down, and I'll show you how I do that, but I'm not someone to fall asleep easily, so I don't fall asleep. It just helps me get into a different stage before I wake up. So what you're going to do is you're going to do Savasana. So if you're familiar with yoga, it's the corpse pose, the dead man's pose. So you're just going to lay flat down on your back. You can put a little bolster if you want under your knees, but it's corpse pose. So you're just laying flat. Your legs are about shoulder width apart. Your hands are splayed out at your side, palms open. And you would just do your deep breathing and your meditation right from here. Now, one reason to do this in the morning, for me personally, I'm waking up slowly, so I'm in that theta state. So I'm awake, but I didn't get out of bed yet, so I'm not fully awake. And that theta state for me is the easiest way for me to get into a more silent or a mantra meditation. So that's what I do. When I walk with my dogs, I do like to find a hillside or a rock to sit on and sit in that yoga position. But in the West, we found a different way to meditate that helps us less flexible Westerners to get into a comfortable meditation. So let me show you that next. So the third way, and actually there's more, but if you know me, you know we like to do things in threes, us and Tesla. So the third way is more of the Western style of meditation, and honestly, researchers are finding that this is the best seated position for meditation. Because let's face it, you know, Westerners are not as flexible as some of the yogis in other parts of the world or yoga instructor or so, but most Americans who are starting out meditating, this is the best way. You don't want your body bound up, because you'll cut blood flow off, your feet will fall asleep, your legs might get tingly. You don't want to do that. You want to be comfortable. So researchers found that sitting in a chair, both feet planted flat on the floor, palms in your hands, they can be on or up, is what they're finding is the best way, keeping your spine straight and then just for relaxation. Your body can sustain that and keep itself awake rather than falling asleep. So you can be mindful of your meditation. Now I'll add a few little things of my own to that. So when I would teach meditation, I would prefer this situation as well, because I don't want people falling asleep in my studio. I want them to stay awake and be with me while I'm guiding the meditation. And when we would sometimes get young girls in who were very flexible, even they who were sitting and contorting themselves in all these positions, after a while got out of their contorted positions and sat like this too, because my guided meditations could go on for a while. So what you want to do is keep those feet planted on the ground, preferably without shoes on, or maybe just socks, no leather between you and Mother Earth. You get that connection. Just, you know, I tend to close my eyes because I'm visualizing that kind of energy flowing from Mother Earth up to me and vice versa, right? So you want to be grounded to Mother Earth. And because I do guided meditations that are often divinely channeled, we want that information and whatever information that needs to come through to that person. Think about it as this field of infinite knowledge that's all around us. And when you're vibrating at a specific frequency, you'll tap into different channels out there. So you want your hands open to receive that information. information, right? There's an energy center right in the center of our hands. This is going to go through our whole body. So you want to keep your hands, palms facing up, in my case, my preferred way. Up and loose, nothing closed, up and loose. You can take that deep breath in here. When you're sitting like this, you have room to expand your belly, to expand the diaphragm, to bring in those relaxation breaths. And as you've seen in my other videos, that's when we release pressure on the vagus nerve, all of our organs relax, we go into the parasympathetic state, we're in rest and digest, and we are ready to meditate. So get your vibe on, choose your position, the one that works best for you, and meditate, meditate, meditate. That's one way to be your own guru. Namaste.
So if you like the information that I've shared with you in this video, please, please, please like, subscribe, and share. Let me know in the comments section. And please remember what your mother may have told you, at least what my mother did. If you don't have anything nice to say, don't say anything at all. Because we know whenever you throw out negativity to someone else, it'll just come right back to you tenfold. So don't do that to yourself or me. So please like, please subscribe, please follow, so you can get more tips and tricks on becoming your own guru.